There's breaking news in the world of RC aircraft or drones. The FAA says 7 companies have asked for permission to use these aircraft in television and film production. And the FAA is considering their request for exemptions that would allow these aircraft to be used legally for the first time. Stay on frequency for this special edition of AeroSpaceNews.com. I'm the editor, Craig, and we'll be right back. Hope you like those graphics. That was our entire 2014 graphics budget. Actually, we've been working on a feature story on this subject for some time, which is actually why we developed those. The news, however, on June the 2nd from the FAA is something that we think really merits its own little special story, which is why we're coming to you with this today. Now, before you get your hopes up, this is not the FAA saying that you can now do aerial photography and aerial video with RC aircraft, aka drones, in the USA legally. At least that's the FAA's position. I know that there are people out there that feel differently. However, this is very interesting because it's a press release directly from the FAA saying that 7 companies have come to them to apply for exemptions to the rules, and the FAA is acknowledging the receipt of that request and saying that it came from a respected motion picture production industry trade group. Here's a bit more detail about what we know so far, and the details are actually still pretty thin. First, 7 aerial photo and video production companies have asked for regulatory exemptions that would allow the film and television industry to use unmanned aerial systems, UAS, or RC aircraft or drones, with the FAA's approval for the very first time. The FAA did not say if they would grant the exemptions, just that they were requested. The Motion Picture Association of America facilitated the exemption requests on behalf of their membership. The firms that filed the petitions are, according to the FAA, all independent aerial cinematography professionals who collectively developed the exemption requests as a requirement to satisfy the safety and public interest concerns of the FAA, MPAA, and the public at large. 3 other industries have also made such requests, including something called precision agriculture, power line and pipeline inspection, and oil and gas flare stack inspection. They are all asking for the FAA to grant exemptions from regulations that address general flight rules, pilot certificate requirements, manuals, maintenance, and equipment mandates. According to the FAA, they are also asking for relief from airworthiness certification requirements as allowed under Section 333 of the FAA Modernization and Reform Act of 2012. Now, the agency says that under that section of the law, certain airworthiness requirements can be waived to let specific unmanned aerial systems fly safely in narrowly defined, controlled, low-risk situations. Next, the agency also says that to receive the exemptions, the firms must show that their unmanned aerial system operations will not adversely affect safety or provide at least an equal level of safety to the rules from which they seek exemption. They would also need to show why granting the exemption would be in the public interest, and that sounds pretty vague to me. At the moment, only so-called public entities such as law enforcement and firefighting have access to such waivers, though commercial operations may be authorized on a, quote, case-by-case basis. Without a waiver, commercial flight requires a certified aircraft, a licensed pilot, and operating approval, says the FAA. We'll be right back. this is a highly controversial topic, and there are lots of folks that have very strong opinions about this issue, including whether or not the FAA is actually legally empowered to regulate the RC community at all, or whether or not people in the RC community have been acting responsibly. We're not taking a position on it. This is not an opinion piece. However, if you'd like to read a webpage that kind of provides some balanced perspective on it, it's actually on the side of our sponsor, AeronauticPictures.com, and there's a link to that right in the description of this video. I'd really, really like to know what your opinion is, but I'd like you to please express it politely and professionally. Please leave a comment or ask a question here in the video if you're on YouTube, or come to AeroSpaceNews.com and leave a comment there. And while we're on the subject of comments, we'd really appreciate it if you could go check out our exclusive tilt rotor video on the history of the V-22 Osprey and tilt rotor technology. Watch some of the installments in that series and give some comment love to those videos. You might also want to check out our Hot Picks series. There's videos on the 747, the F-18, Super Hornet, and also the X-47 there, and leave some comment love there. And by the way, if you're over the age of 40, comment love means, would you please mind going to the video and expressing your opinions in the form of a comment, politely and professionally. Be sure to check out these other great videos on our YouTube channel. Make sure you head over to AeroSpaceNews.com, where we have exclusive photos and other great content that you won't see on YouTube. And be sure to subscribe to our channel on YouTube and follow us on Twitter. Until next time, we really appreciate you watching, and we look forward to seeing you next time on The Leading Edge. Welcome. Why am I suddenly out of focus?